never be more loved than I am right now. Wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now.
Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice carried in the rhythm of the wind to call me out. You would cross an ocean, so I wouldn't drown. You've never been closer than you are right now.
Let's sing it all, y'all.
You are a
so clear what it's all about.
Just stay by my side when the sun goes down. Don't wanna forget how I feel right now.
Gyro,
Gyro,
you
are enough.
I know that you are
Gyro,
you are
enough.
So I will be
Good morning, CFF. It's so good to have you on this Resurrection Sunday. We are here because Jesus is alive. Come on, is Jesus alive? I know he is in your heart, in this place, in your home. So why don't you get on your feet and let's start singing with our hearts. Let's start praising Jesus. Come on, he's given you life.
Hey. I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my failures I try to hide. It was my turn till I met you. Oh, you called my name and I ran out of that grave. Out of the darkness into
you, Jesus.
Now your freedom is all that I know.
Listen to this.
The old thing new. Jesus, when I met you.
Yeah. Listen to this, guys. In Romans 8:11, the Word of God says, "And if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you, He who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies because of His Spirit who lives in you." Come on, if you believe in that word today, would you shout, "Thank you, Jesus"?
I needed rescue, my sin was heavy. The chains break out the weight of your glory. I needed shelter, I was an orphan. But you called me a citizen of heaven. When I was broken, you were my healing. Now your love is the air that I'm breathing. I have a future, my eyes are open. Cause when you call my name, and I ran out of that grave, out of the darkness into your glorious day.
To be praised, amen. You're worthy, Jesus. We'll never stop singing to you. You called out into darkness. You reached down to save us. You conquered the grave, you crossed the divide. Lost in our sin, you made us alive. How can we ever hold it inside? We can't hold back. We're gonna lift you high, high. Hearts burning bright like a fire, fire. Voices unite. Lift him up, lift him up.
burning bright like the fire, fire. Voices unite, they're getting louder, louder. We're never gonna stop singing. Ooh, never gonna stop. Higher, higher. Hearts burning bright like a fire, fire. Voices unite, they're getting louder, louder. We're never gonna stop singing. Ooh, never gonna stop singing. Oh, 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 we'll never stop, Jesus. We'll never stop singing your name. You're worthy, Lord. Oh, you're worthy. Come on, lift your hands to the risen King, 'cause He is worthy. He is worthy.
Why don't you say that with me? Jesus, you are worthy. You are risen. We believe that you died on the cross and you rose again for our salvation. Amen? How many people can say amen in the house of God?
Your presence is an open door. We want you, Lord, like never before. Your presence is an open door. So come now, Lord, like never before. Oh, like never before, Lord. Your spirit is welcomed here.
Just invite you in this moment. Come on, let these next few seconds be moments with the Lord that you will never forget. Just draw near to Him. Just draw near to Him. Draw near to Him. Make your home a dwelling place for the Holy Spirit. I invite you to fall to your knees or to raise your arms, your voices, wherever you are. Tell Him we're hungry. fire within. Let our passion rise again. We will never be the same. We are changed. We are changed in you. Oh, we are changed in you. We are changed in you. Just pour out your heart. Come on, make this your prayer. Ignite my heart again, Jesus. Ignite our passion again, God. Oh, this is our moment. Where the people of God are being called to rise up again. To ignite the fire. Oh, just come, Holy Spirit. Oh. 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 Hey. Oh. Oh.
Hey, good morning. My name is Marcos.
Buenos días. Mi nombre es Marcos.
And this is Chris.
Y él es Cristian.
And we are here to share a message with you.
Y estamos aquí para compartir un mensaje contigo.
And I'm here to tell you how faithful God is.
Y estoy aquí para decirte que fiel es Dios.
And that He has an amazing life for you.
Y él tiene una gran vida para ti.
Chris, have you ever had a dream?
Cristian, ¿alguna vez has tenido un sueño?
That you wake up every morning.
En el cual te despiertas cada mañana.
And it moves you.
Y te mueve.
It re-energizes you.
Te llena de energía una vez más.
And it excites you.
Y te emociona.
Have you ever been in that situation?
¿Has estado en esa situación? Sí.
Yes. Especially the dreams that God has for you.
Especialmente aquellos sueños que Dios tiene para ti.
And I know many of you here.
Y yo sé que muchos de ustedes aquí.
Or listening.
O los que están escuchando.
God has given you a dream.
Dios te ha dado un sueño.
But many times in life.
Pero muchas veces en la vida.
Things happen.
Ciertas cosas pasan.
And little by little,
y poco a poco,
you start walking away.
Te empiezas a alejar.
With bitterness,
con a la mejor amargura,
resentment,
resentimiento,
or you no longer believe,
o ya no crees,
that God will come through,
que Dios va a cumplir la promesa.
And if this is you today,
y si ese eres tú hoy,
I am here to give you an amazing message.
Estoy aquí para compartir un gran mensaje
that will bless not just myself,
que te bendecirá no solamente
but
a mí,
all of you listening to this.
Pero a cada persona escuchando.
In the book of Genesis from 37 through 50,
en el libro de Génesis del capítulo 37 al 50,
it talks about Joseph the dreamer.
Habla de la vida de José el soñador.
That he had a dream.
Que él tenía un sueño.
That he ruled over his family,
en el cual él iba a gobernar a su familia,
which includes his parents and his brothers,
incluyendo a sus papás y hermanos.
And he ended up telling this dream to his family.
Y él les contó ese sueño a sus hermanos.
And they pretty much ended up hating him.
Y lo terminaron odiando.
And eventually,
y eventualmente,
his brothers ended up selling him into slavery.
Sus hermanos lo vendieron como esclavo.
He ended up going to prison.
Él terminó en la prisión.
Because he was accused of taking advantage of a woman.
Porque fue acusado de abusar de una mujer.
And a lot of things happened in his life.
Y muchas cosas pasaron en su vida.
That if those things happened to us,
que a lo mejor si te pasaran a ti o a mí,
we would probably give up on life.
Nos rendiríamos en la vida.
But the difference between this man and us,
pero la diferencia entre este hombre y nosotros,
this man kept on to the dream of God.
Esta persona se pudo aferrar a la promesa de Dios.
Now I encourage you today to keep that dream of God for your life.
Al sueño de Dios, y te motivo que hoy puedas hacer tú lo mismo.
That at the end of this story,
que al final de la historia,
his father ended up passing away.
Su papá terminó muriéndose.
After they reunited with Joseph.
Después de que se volvieron a juntar una vez más.
After so many years.
Después de muchos años.
So his brothers came up to him.
Así que sus hermanos se le acercaron.
And asked him.
Y le preguntaron.
Now that our father has died.
Ahora que nuestro padre ha muerto.
What will you do to us?
¿Qué nos vas a hacer a nosotros?
And I thought it was awesome what Joseph told his brothers.
Y a mí me parece increíble la respuesta de José.
He told them,
les contesta,
I am not God to judge you.
Yo no soy Dios para juzgarte.
But everything that you meant for bad,
pero todo lo que intentaron hacer para mal,
God meant it for good.
Dios lo transformó para bien.
He ended up being governor of Egypt.
Él se volvió el gobernador de Egipto.
Right, so in that same way,
y de esa misma manera,
I know God has something amazing for us.
Yo sé que Dios tiene algo maravilloso para nosotros.
That no matter how long it takes,
y no importa cuánto tarde en llegar,
that usually indicates,
eso generalmente indica,
that God has something greater for us.
Que Dios tiene algo mayor para nosotros.
Because our character will be formed.
Porque nuestro carácter está siendo formado.
So that we may be able to take care of what God will give us.
Para poder manejar y desarrollar eso que Dios nos quiere dar.
I know that out of this ministry,
y yo sé que de este ministerio,
God will raise up,
Dios levantará,
businessmen,
hombres de negocio,
congressmen,
personas en
lawyers,
el gobierno, gobernadores, perdón, y también abogados.
And you will be the man or the woman.
Y tú serás el hombre o la mujer.
In that mission field.
En ese campo misionero.
That when you're faithful,
que cuando tú eres fiel,
to the calling of God,
al llamado de Dios,
he will be faithful to you.
Él será fiel contigo también.
So I encourage you to be faithful in your tithes and offerings.
Así que te motivo a ser fiel con tus diezmos y ofrendas.
Just like it says in Hebrews 10:23.
Así como dice en Hebreos 10:23.
Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for he who promised is faithful.
Mantengamos firme la esperanza que profesamos, porque fiel es el que hizo la promesa.
That no matter what happens in your life,
que no importa lo que pase en tu vida,
stay firm,
que tú puedas
stay
mantenerte
faithful,
firme y fiel,
do not waver,
y que no te rindas.
That despite of it all,
que a pesar de todo,
despite of the bad things,
a pesar de las cosas malas,
God meant it for good.
Dios lo va a transformar para bueno.
That you will be able to say at the end of it all,
y tú podrás decir al final de todo,
when people ask you, how are you so blessed? Why are you walking in abundance?
Cuando la gente te pregunte, ¿por qué eres tan bendecido? ¿Por qué caminas en bendición?
And you'll be able to say that no matter everything that went through my life, God meant it for good.
Que tú puedas decir, todo lo que yo pasé, Dios lo transformó en algo bueno.
Something greater is about to happen in your life.
Algo maravilloso y grandioso está por pasarte a ti.
You must remain faithful.
Tienes que permanecer fiel.
And if this is you today,
y si este eres tú hoy,
I encourage you to hold the hand of the person next to you.
Te motivo que agarres la mano de la persona que está a tu lado.
Close your eyes and I want to pray for you.
Cierren sus ojos, yo quiero orar por ustedes.
And say, Father God,
di conmigo, Señor Jesús,
thank you so much.
Gracias.
Because I know,
porque yo sé,
that you are faithful.
Que tú eres fiel.
And I know, God,
y yo sé, Dios,
that you are taking me to another level.
Que tú me estás llevando a un siguiente nivel.
See my faithfulness.
Ve mi fidelidad.
Just as you are faithful to me.
Así como tú eres fiel conmigo.
Help me.
Ayúdame, Dios.
Remove these limits from my life.
Remueve estos límites de mi vida.
So I may see.
Para que yo pueda ver.
Greater things.
Cosas mayores.
To walk in abundance.
Para caminar en abundancia.
And to be a blessing.
Y poder ser de bendición.
To everyone around me.
A cada persona a mi alrededor.
We love you, Lord.
Te amamos, Dios.
Bless these tithes.
Bendice estos diezmos.
And offerings, Lord.
Y ofrendas, Dios.
We love you.
Te amamos.
In Jesus' name.
En el nombre de Jesús.
Amen.
Amen.
There are three different ways you can give to CFF. Number one, you can give online. Head over to givecff.com to give using a credit card or a debit card. You can give a one-time offering or you can sign up to give a monthly gift to CFF. Number two, you can send a text message to 84321 to set up your giving profile on our site, or you can also download the Church Center app and set up your profile that way. Number three, you can send a check to CFF. Send your check to 6701 East Olympic Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90022. We don't want anyone to miss out on the blessing of giving. We pray God's blessing on your finances, your home, your family, everything in your life.
Good morning, CFF. So good to be with you one more time.
Muy buenos días, Centro Familiar de Fe. Es un gozo estar con ustedes una vez más.
This is the best day of the year.
Este es el mejor día del año.
It is Resurrection Sunday.
Es Domingo de Resurrección.
It's the day that changed everything for us.
Es el día en el cual cambió todo para nosotros.
I love Christmas, don't get me wrong.
A mí me encanta la Navidad, no me malinterpretes.
It's when we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ.
Es obviamente cuando celebramos el nacimiento de Jesucristo.
But if he was born,
pero si él hubiera nacido,
and he died,
y ha muerto,
and if he didn't resurrect,
y si no hubiera resucitado,
then Christmas meant nothing.
Entonces la Navidad no significaría
the
nada.
Only reason why we celebrate Christmas,
la única razón por la cual celebramos Navidad,
is because Jesus was risen.
Es porque Jesucristo resucitó.
Because our Jesus, our Christ,
porque nuestro Cristo, nuestro Jesús,
our God,
nuestro Dios,
he's not buried in a tomb.
No está sepultado en una tumba.
You could find Muhammad in a tomb.
Tú puedes encontrar a Muhammad en una tumba.
You could find John Smith's remains.
Puedes encontrar los restos de John Smith.
You could find Buddha's remains.
Puedes encontrar los restos de Buda.
But Jesus is not in a grave.
Pero Jesucristo no está en una tumba.
He's not in a tomb, he was risen. He is risen.
Él resucitó. Él no se encuentra en una tumba.
You see this incredible difference between those that believe in Jesus and those that don't.
Esta es la gran diferencia entre los que creen en Cristo y los que no creen.
I believe that there's a lot of people that yes, they believe in God, but they don't believe in a risen Jesus.
Yo creo que hay mucha gente que cree en Dios, pero no creen en un Jesucristo que ha resucitado.
I believe that there's a lot of Christians.
Yo creo que hay muchos cristianos
that they believe in God and they believe that Jesus died for their sins.
Que creen en Dios y creen que Jesús murió por sus pecados.
But I don't think they're constantly aware that Jesus is risen.
Pero no creo que están conscientes constantemente de que Cristo resucitó.
Jesus is risen.
Jesucristo ha resucitado.
He defeated death.
Él venció a la muerte.
The grave couldn't hold him down.
La muerte no lo pudo detener.
No stone can hold back the power of Jesus.
Ninguna piedra pudo detener el poder de Jesús.
Today I want to share with you one of the most beautiful stories that I found in the scripture.
Y yo quiero compartir contigo esta mañana una de las historias más hermosas que encuentro en la Biblia.
It's found in the book of Mark chapter 16.
Se encuentra en Marcos capítulo 16.
And we're only going to read a few verses, 16, 1 through 8.
Y solamente vamos a leer del 1 al 8.
I'm going to read it in English and then you're going to find it in Spanish in subtitles.
Y lo vamos a leer solamente en inglés y lo encontrarás en español en la parte de abajo.
And it says like this. When the Sabbath was over, Mark chapter 16 verse 1 through 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene and Mary the mother of James and Salome bought spices so that they might come and anoint him. Him meaning Jesus. Very early on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb when the sun had risen. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll away the stone for us from the entrance of the tomb?" Looking up, they saw that the stone had been already rolled away, though it was extremely large. Entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting at the right, wearing a white robe, and they were amazed. And he said to them, "Do not be amazed. You are looking for Jesus the Nazarene, who has been crucified. He has risen. He's not here. Behold, he is. Here is the place where they lay him. But go, tell his disciples and Peter. He's going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him, just as he told you." They went out and fled from the tomb, for trembling and astonishment had gripped them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid. Close your eyes with me, let's pray.
Cierren sus ojos, vamos a orar.
Dear God, thank you so much.
Señor, gracias.
For your love and your grace.
Por tu amor y por tu gracia.
We ask you to speak to us through your word.
Te pedimos que hables a través de tu palabra.
Would you change our hearts, please?
Cambia nuestros corazones.
Speak to us, please.
Háblanos, Señor.
Thank you so much, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
For the fact that we can read your words.
Por el hecho de que podemos leer tus palabras.
And be transformed by them.
Y ser transformadas
por
ellas.
We pray,
en tu nombre oramos.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Y amen.
Man, I've read the Bible and I've read this story so many times.
Yo leo la Biblia y he leído esta historia muchas veces.
And I can tell you this, I have preached it, I have taught it, and every time I find something new, every time I find something beautiful.
Y te puedo decir que la he compartido varias veces, pero cada vez que la leo encuentro algo nuevo y hermoso.
I want to focus on it's really like 5 or 6 simple words that were said in Matthew chapter 16 verse 3.
Quiero enfocarme en cinco palabras que fueron dichas en Marcos 16:3.
It says that these women, Mary and Salome, right? These women, they were going to see Jesus' body.
Dice que estas dos Marías iban camino a ver el cuerpo de Jesús.
They were on their way to anoint the body of Jesus Christ.
Iban camino para ungir el cuerpo de Jesús.
I want you to picture this, that after this horrible day, the most difficult day in these women's lives.
Quiero que te imagines esto, después del día más horrible en el día de estas mujeres.
They had just seen their Lord, their Savior, crucified.
Acababan de ver a su Jesucristo, su Salvador, ser crucificado.
They had seen Jesus being beaten nearly to death.
Habían visto a Jesucristo ser golpeado a punto de muerte.
Then they saw him hanging on a cross, naked.
Y luego lo vieron ser colgado en una cruz desnudo.
While he was bleeding out,
mientras él se desangraba,
people would scream abuses to him.
La gente le gritaba maldiciones a él.
And these women who loved Jesus,
y estas mujeres que amaban a Jesús,
who believed in Jesus,
que creían en él,
their world was falling apart.
Su mundo se caía en pedazos.
What a dark day that must have been.
Qué día tan oscuro en el cual se encontraban ellas.
All the people that at some point received blessings from Jesus turned their back on him.
La mayoría de las personas que recibieron bendición de Dios de Jesús le dieron la espalda.
Most of his disciples walked away from Jesus.
La mayoría de sus discípulos se alejaron de Jesús.
But these women did not.
Pero estas dos mujeres no lo hicieron.
These women remained faithful.
Estas mujeres permanecieron fiel.
These women loved Jesus.
Estas mujeres amaban a Jesús.
And even after what seemed to be the most defeating day in history.
Y a pesar de que después del día más difícil en la historia.
After they thought that it was over, after their hearts were gripped with darkness.
Después de que pensaron que se había acabado todo y sus días estaban llenos de obscuridad,
they still wanted to honor Jesus.
Querían seguir honrando a Jesús.
While some of his disciples had turned their back on him, these women wanted to anoint the body of Jesus. They wanted to clean the blood of his face.
Cuando algunos discípulos ya le habían dado la espalda a Jesús, estas mujeres querían ungir a Jesús y limpiar su rostro.
In spite of their sadness, they still wanted to do something good for their Lord.
Sin importar su tristeza, aún así querían hacer algo bueno y lindo para su Jesús.
And I want you to walk with these women for just a second. They're on their way to the tomb.
Y quiero que camines con estas mujeres por un segundo. Van camino a la tumba.
I could imagine that they had already spent their money. They had purchased all these herbs, all these things to anoint the body of Jesus.
Me imagino que se habían gastado todo su dinero comprando estas hierbas y aceite para ungir el cuerpo de Jesús.
They were perhaps crying as they were remembering every scene of the cross.
A lo mejor estaban llorando mientras se recordaban de cada escena de la cruz.
And they were about to get to the tomb.
Y están a punto de llegar a la tumba.
And one of them said to the other,
y una le dice a la otra,
who will roll away the stone?
¿Quién nos quitará la piedra?
Who will roll away the stone?
¿Quién moverá la piedra?
Let me repeat that again. Who will roll away the stone?
Voy a repetir esto una vez más. ¿Quién moverá la piedra?
You see, what had happened is that the governors at that time, the I guess you could say the ruling, the people that ruled the nation, or the people that were in power.
Lo que te quiero decir es que la gente que tenía el poder en ese entonces.
The religious leaders, the governors.
Los líderes religiosos, los gobernadores.
They were so afraid that the disciples would take the body of Jesus.
Tenían tanto miedo de que los discípulos se robaran el cuerpo de Jesús.
And make it seem like he had resurrected.
Y lo hicieran ver como si Jesús hubiera resucitado.
That they had extra precautions to protect that body.
Así que tomaron precauciones extras para proteger ese cuerpo.
The Bible tells us that they put soldiers surrounding the tomb.
La Biblia nos dice que pusieron soldados alrededor de la tumba.
These were highly trained Roman soldiers.
Estos eran soldados entrenados a alto nivel.
They didn't only do that, they rolled this huge stone on top of this grave to cover it.
Y no solamente eso, sino que pusieron una piedra enorme en la tumba para cubrirla.
Then they put the seal of the emperor. They put the seal as to not be broken, meaning if anybody breaks the seal, they will be put to death.
Y pusieron el sello del gobernador para que nadie la pudiera mover, y si alguien se atrevía a hacerlo, lo hubieran matado.
Number one, they had to go through the guards.
Número uno, tenían que pasar los guardias.
Then they had to bring enough manpower to move this huge stone.
Número dos, tenían que traer suficientes hombres para mover esta enorme piedra.
And number three, they had to be willing to risk their lives in order to do this thing.
Y número tres, tenían que estar dispuestos a arriesgar su vida para hacer esto.
And yet these women still say, Who's going to roll away the stone?
Y estas mujeres inclusive no así dijeron, ¿quién moverá esta piedra?
All they wanted to was to anoint the body of Jesus.
Lo único que querían era ungir el cuerpo de
they
Jesús.
Didn't have permission from the government.
No tenían permiso del gobernador.
They didn't talk to the religious people.
No hablaban con los religiosos.
All they wanted to was just to anoint the body of Jesus.
Lo único que querían era ungir el cuerpo de Jesús.
And listen to what happened next.
Y escucha lo que pasa
después. The Bible says that the stone was already rolled away.
La Biblia dice que la piedra ya había sido movida.
That the stone had been removed, and it says in the book of Matthew, actually, that the angel was sitting on the stone.
La Biblia dice en el libro de Mateo que el ángel estaba sentado en la piedra.
And he tells them, "Who are you looking for? Because Jesus is not here; he's risen."
Y el ángel les pregunta, "¿Quién buscan? Porque Jesucristo no está aquí; él ha resucitado."
What an amazing thing to hear.
Qué cosa tan maravillosa escuchar.
The Bible says that these women were so afraid.
La Biblia dice que estas mujeres tenían tanto miedo.
But it also says that they were filled with joy.
Pero también dice que fueron llenas de gozo.
I love this part of the story.
Me encanta esta historia.
Because when I hear who will roll away the stone,
porque cuando yo escucho quién moverá esta piedra,
I believe that people still need to ask that same question in their own lives.
Yo creo que la gente se tiene que hacer esa pregunta en sus propias vidas.
Who will roll away the stone?
¿Quién moverá esta piedra?
There are many stones in our lives.
Hay tantas piedras.
Many things that seem so difficult that there's no way that I can move them.
Hay tantas cosas en nuestra vida que parecen tan difíciles que yo no las puedo mover.
There are stones in our lives.
Hay piedras en nuestras
that
vidas.
That unless God moves them, there's no way that we can move them.
Que a menos que Dios las mueva, no hay manera que nosotros las podamos mover.
There are all kinds of stones.
Hay todo tipo de piedras.
Stones that stop us from getting closer to God.
Piedras que nos detienen para acercarnos a Dios.
Stones that stop us from seeing the true revelation of the Son of God.
A piedras que nos detienen de ver la revelación completa de Jesucristo.
There are stones in our lives.
Hay piedras en nuestras vidas.
And we need to ask God to remove the stones from us.
Y tenemos que pedir a Dios que remueva esas piedras de nosotros.
There are stones of unbelief.
Hay piedras de falta de creencia.
There are stones of confusion.
Piedras de confusión.
Stones that stop you from seeing the revelation of the true Son of God.
Piedras que te detienen de ver la revelación de la verdad de Jesucristo.
In many people there are stones of hatred, of jealousy.
En muchas personas hay piedras de enojo, de celo.
Maybe there are big stones in your life of unforgiveness that stops you from seeing Jesus.
A lo mejor hay grandes piedras de falta de perdón que te detienen de ver a Jesús.
Who will roll away the stone?
¿Quién moverá esa piedra?
Maybe in your life there may be a big stone of anxiety, of fear.
A lo mejor en tu vida hay una gran piedra de ansiedad, de miedo.
I believe that there's a big stone in many, many people that they just simply don't know what's going to happen in the future.
Yo creo que hay una gran piedra en la vida de varias personas que no saben qué va a pasar en el futuro.
This uncontrolled sadness.
Esta tristeza sin control.
Who will roll away the stone?
¿Quién moverá esta piedra?
Some people perhaps have uncontrolled anger.
A lo mejor para otras personas es no poder controlar el enojo.
And maybe it's uncontrolled lust.
A lo mejor es lujuria sin control.
Maybe it seems so big that they say, God, I can't do it. Who's going to move that stone
for
me?
A lo mejor es tan grande que dicen, Dios, no sé cómo hacerle. ¿Quién moverá esta piedra de mi vida?
How about that stone of pride?
¿Qué tal esa piedra de orgullo?
That stops you from seeing Jesus.
Que te detiene de ver a Jesús.
I would say today we ask the same question, who's going to move the stone?
Hoy te digo que te hagas esa pregunta, ¿quién moverá esta piedra?
There are so many stones in our lives.
Hay tantas piedras en nuestra vida.
That God wants to move.
Que Dios quiere mover.
The Bible says that there was this huge earthquake.
La Biblia dice que hubo un gran terremoto.
While the angel was rolling away the stone.
Cuando el ángel movía la piedra.
I believe that God is sending angels to roll away your stones.
Yo creo que Dios está mandando ángeles para mover esas piedras.
All those stones that I just described, God wants to remove them so that you could see his love, his grace, his kindness, his power.
Aquellas piedras que te acabo de describir, Dios las quiere mover para que puedas ver su amor, su poder.
In this world.
En este mundo,
there are so many people that desperately want to see Jesus.
Hay tanta gente que desesperadamente tiene que ver a Jesús.
But they don't even want to get close.
Pero no se quieren acercar.
Because of the pressure of people.
Por la presión de la gente.
Maybe you want to see Jesus.
A lo mejor tú quieres ver a Jesús.
But there are stones in front of you, like I said, the stones of pride.
Pero hay piedras, como te dije, a lo mejor de orgullo.
Or you want to see Jesus.
O quieres ver a Jesús.
But there are stones of your past.
Pero hay piedras de tu pasado.
Stones that you say, yeah, I want to see him, but come on, who's going to move that stone?
Piedras que dices, lo quiero ver, pero ¿quién moverá esta piedra?
And I'm believing that God is going to remove all the stones today that stop you from seeing the hand of God.
Y yo creo que Dios quiere mover esas piedras que te detienen de ver su mano en tu vida.
Can I ask you just a genuine question?
¿Te puedo hacer una pregunta genuina?
Have you ever thought about this?
¿Has pensado lo siguiente?
Do I really believe that Jesus has risen?
¿Realmente creo que Jesús resucitó?
I mean, really, do you really believe that Jesus is alive?
¿Realmente crees que Jesús está vivo?
I don't mean, do you go to church?
Yo no me refiero a, ¿vas a la iglesia?
I don't mean, do you read the Bible?
O ¿lees la Biblia?
Or do you sing the Christian songs?
¿O cantas las canciones cristianas?
Or do you have a mom that is a believer?
¿O tienes una mamá que es creyente?
I mean, is Jesus risen for you?
La pregunta es, ¿Jesucristo ha resucitado para ti?
If you cannot answer that question, then there's still a stone in front of you.
Si no puedes responder esa pregunta, hay una piedra en tu vida enfrente de ti.
These women lived very sad, devoted lives.
Estas mujeres vivían vidas muy tristes.
Those 3 days of their lives.
Esos tres días en su vida.
They were perhaps the saddest days.
Eran a lo mejor los días más tristes.
They believed in Jesus.
Creían en Jesús.
But their Jesus was dead.
Pero su Jesucristo estaba muerto.
They believed in Jesus.
Creían en Jesús.
But their Jesus was dead.
Pero su Jesús estaba
he
muerto.
Was still in a tomb. He was buried and controlled by a stone.
Seguía en una tumba muerto y controlado por una piedra.
You know, the angel tells Mary, he says, go find the disciples and tell them what you said. By the way, tell Peter also.
El ángel les dice, ve y cuéntale a los discípulos lo que viste y también dile a Pedro.
Why did he say the disciples and Peter?
¿Por qué les dijo, ve y dile a los discípulos y también a Pedro?
Because Peter's Jesus was in that tomb. Because Peter's Jesus was still dead.
Porque el Jesús de Pedro también estaba muerto, estaba en esa tumba.
Because the disciples were so disillusioned, their lives were so powerless, because Jesus was dead to them.
Porque la vida de sus discípulos estaba tan triste porque su Jesucristo también estaba muerto.
I see so many Christians that are so afraid and so worried during these pandemic times.
Veo a tantos cristianos que están tan preocupados durante estos tiempos de pandemia.
And I'm not saying that we should be unaware.
Y yo no digo que no tengamos conciencia.
But I see so many Christians so caught up into so many things because it seems like their Jesus is dead.
Pero me encuentro con cristianos que están tan atorados porque su Jesucristo sigue muerto.
I was talking to a guy the other day. He was so frustrated. He was against everybody and nobody understood. And the government this and the government that. He was so flustered, so hopeless.
Yo hablaba con una persona que estaba tan enojada, echándole la culpa al gobierno, el gobierno esto, el gobierno lo otro. Esta persona estaba tan llena o sin con tanta falta de esperanza.
And my question was, do you believe that Jesus is alive?
Y mi pregunta fue, ¿crees que Jesús está vivo?
Do you believe that Jesus rose from the dead?
¿Crees que Jesús resucitó de la muerte?
Do you believe that he still has power over the government, over the seal that sealed that tomb closed?
¿Crees que Jesús tiene el poder sobre el gobernador, inclusive sobre ese sello que trató de sellar la
tierra? Do you understand what I'm saying?
¿Entiendes lo que te digo?
The plans of God will not be stopped, not by government, not by the force or the strength of men.
Los planes de Dios no podrán ser detenidos por el gobierno, por el poder del hombre.
The forces of nature couldn't stop Jesus from raising from the dead.
Las fuerzas de la naturaleza no pudieron detener a Jesucristo de resucitar.
If death couldn't stop him, what makes you think that a human being can stop him?
Si ni la muerte pudo detener, ¿qué te hace pensar que un hombre lo puede detener?
Yet why is it that some believers live lives?
¿Por qué hay creyentes que viven vida
with such desperation?
Con tanta desesperación.
So many people are so afraid.
Hay tanta gente que tiene tanto miedo.
I think Christians sometimes are so afraid because they don't have the fear of God.
Creo que hay cristianos que tienen tanto miedo porque no tienen el temor del
the
Señor.
More you fear God,
mientras más le temes a Dios,
the less you fear men.
Menos le temes a los hombres.
The more you fear God,
mientras más le temes al Señor,
the less you fear men.
Menos le temes a los hombres.
You don't fear a dead God.
Tú no le
You don't fear a dead God.
Tú no le temes a un Dios muerto.
So many people don't fear God because to them God is not alive. God is not risen.
Hay tanta gente que no le tiene miedo al Señor porque no está vivo en ellos.
Let me put it like this.
Lo voy a poner de esta manera.
To me,
para mí,
Jesus is alive.
Jesucristo está vivo.
My Jesus defeated death.
Mi Jesucristo venció a la muerte.
My Jesus conquered the grave.
Mi Jesucristo venció la tumba.
Jesus is alive.
Jesucristo vive.
Jesus is alive.
Jesucristo está vivo.
Let me ask you that question again.
Déjame hacerte esa pregunta.
Is Jesus risen or is he still in a tomb?
¿Jesús está vivo o sigue en una tumba?
You know, that is the biggest question you need to answer today.
Esa es la mayor pregunta que tienes que responder
and
hoy.
And perhaps is the biggest question you will need to answer in your entire life.
Y a lo mejor es la mayor pregunta que tienes que responder en tu vida entera.
Is a question that opens the floodgates of joy.
Es la pregunta que abre las ventanas del gozo.
Either you live in joy or you live in judgment.
Vives en gozo o en juicio.
Because if you don't decide that Jesus is alive,
porque si tú no decides que Jesucristo vive,
then Jesus couldn't have paid for your sins.
Entonces Jesucristo no puede pagar por tus pecados.
Then Jesus is just another religious figure.
Entonces Jesucristo es solamente una figura religiosa.
Then God is powerless.
Entonces Dios no tiene poder.
And yes, you should enjoy this life and be worried about losing it because you don't have a life after.
Y sí, debes de preocuparte de perder esta vida porque no tendrás una vida después.
But if Jesus is alive,
pero si Jesucristo vive,
and if what he said is true,
y lo que él dice es verdad,
if indeed after 3 days Jesus conquered the grave,
si en realidad en 3 días él venció la muerte,
if that soul really is the stone really was rolled away,
si realmente esa piedra fue movida,
then death is so different to you.
Entonces la muerte es tan diferente para
Let
ti.
Let me explain it like this.
Lo voy a explicar de esta manera.
When Jesus talks about this life,
cuando Jesús habla de esta vida,
he speaks about it so different than we talk about life.
Él habla tan diferente de como nosotros lo hablamos.
To him, this life is simply part of the journey onto an amazing destiny.
Para él esta vida es parte del camino hasta llegar al destino final.
But to so many people that don't have a risen Jesus, this life is all they have.
Pero para tanta gente que no creen en el Jesús vivo, esta vida es todo lo que tienen.
And I'm not saying we shouldn't love the gift that God has given us, which is life.
Y no te digo que no ames el regalo que Dios nos ha dado, que es esta vida.
What I am saying to you is the following.
Lo que te digo es lo siguiente.
That there is so much more.
Que hay muchísimo más.
And what you do in this life really does matter unto eternity.
Y lo que haces en esta vida realmente importa para la eternidad.
You see, my father died when I was very young.
Mi papá murió cuando yo era muy pequeño.
But my father is alive today because he is risen in Jesus Christ.
Pero mi papá vive hoy porque él resucitó con Cristo Jesús.
Why am I telling you this?
¿Por qué te digo esto?
Because even the grave,
porque inclusive la tumba,
has no power over Jesus.
No tuvo poder sobre Jesús.
And it will not have power over you.
Y no tendrá poder en tu vida.
When Jesus rose from the dead,
cuando Jesucristo resucitó de la tumba,
he was telling us,
él nos decía,
that you will not be held back by the grave either.
Que la tumba no podrá detenernos tampoco.
You see, that rolling away of the stone,
esa piedra movida,
it means so much more than just an amazing miracle.
Significa mucho más que un milagro.
It
nada
means
más.
That there's forgiveness of sins.
Significa que hay perdón para nuestros pecados.
It means that there's a washing away of all iniquity, all the evil deeds.
Significa que todos nuestros pecados son perdonados.
It means that Jesus is conqueror.
Significa que Jesucristo es un conquistador.
It means that God has the final word in your
significa
life.
Significa que Dios tiene la última palabra en tu vida.
Let me put it like this.
Lo voy a poner de esta manera.
I believe.
Yo creo
that Jesus
que Jesús
rose from the dead.
Resucitó de la muerte.
I believe that more than anything I can possibly tell you.
Yo creo eso más que cualquier otra cosa.
I believe it like the air that I breathe.
Yo lo creo como el aire que respiro.
You may be asking yourself, Pastor.
Puede que te preguntes,
how could you
Pastor,
be so sure?
¿Cómo puedes estar tan seguro?
You weren't there, were you?
¿Tú no estabas ahí, o acaso sí?
I have been asked that same question many times.
A mí me han hecho esa pregunta miles de veces.
How could you be so sure?
¿Cómo puedo estar tan seguro?
I can tell you many things, but I simply want to tell you two.
Yo te puedo decir tantas cosas, pero solamente te quiero decir dos.
I want to make sure that this sermon is not just a sermon.
Quiero asegurarme que este sermón no es solamente un sermón.
But it's a word that can inspire you to have hope in a risen Jesus.
Sino una palabra que te puede motivar para tener esperanza en Jesús.
You see, I wasn't there when World War II was fought.
Yo no estaba ahí cuando la Guerra Mundial II fue peleada.
I wasn't there when, you know, when the Germans conceded, when they gave up, when they surrendered.
Yo no estaba ahí cuando los alemanes se rindieron.
But there's two things that tell me that it actually happened.
Pero hay dos cosas que me cuentan que realmente pasó esto.
The first one is that there was a lot of eyewitness accounts. There's a lot of people that saw it and people that tell the stories.
La primera es que hubo muchísimos testigos que vieron esto y gente que puede contar esta historia.
And that is the key word, witness.
Y esa es la palabra clave, testigos.
There were witnesses.
Hubieron testigos.
Credible witnesses.
Testigos creíbles.
Number two.
Número dos.
The reason I believe that World War II happened and that the Germans did not win that war.
La segunda razón por la cual yo sé que la Segunda Guerra Mundial pasó y que los alemanes no ganaron.
Is because the world feels the freedom, the effect of that conquest.
Es porque el mundo puede gozar el gozo de esa libertad.
Because today my life is very different than if the Germans would have won that time.
Porque hoy mi vida es muy diferente que si los alemanes hubieran ganado.
Because I can tell you this with all certainty.
Porque yo te puedo decir esto con tal seguridad.
Even though I wasn't there,
aunque no estuve ahí,
I can see the powerful effects of conquest.
Puedo ver los, el poder de la conquista.
Let me ask you this question.
Te voy a hacer esta pregunta.
Why do you believe that Jesus has risen?
¿Por qué crees que Jesucristo resucitó?
What do you have in your heart that tells you, yes, my Jesus is alive?
¿Qué tienes en tu vida que te puede decir, sí, mi Jesús vive?
Number one thing is that there's so many witnesses of the resurrection of Jesus.
Número uno es que hay tantos testigos de la resurrección de Jesucristo.
We Christians call it witnessing, speaking of the love and life of Jesus.
Nosotros cristianos le llamamos esos testigos que hablan del gozo y de la libertad de Cristo.
Do you know where that word came from when a person goes and testifies?
¿Sabes de dónde viene esa palabra cuando una persona va y testifica?
Because in the beginning, when Jesus died,
porque en el principio cuando Jesús murió,
when the first church was formed, it wasn't formed out of some fable, out of some story.
Cuando la primera iglesia fue fundada, no fue fundada por una farábola.
It wasn't formed because some pastor wanted to preach or because there was lights in a building.
No fue fundada porque un pastor quería predicar o había luces en un edificio.
The church was founded after deep discouragement, after one of the most difficult defeats in human history.
La iglesia fue fundada después de la mayor decepción en la historia.
The church was formed after Jesus died and all the disciples deserted.
La iglesia fue formada después de que Jesús murió y todos los discípulos se rindieron.
When Jesus was crucified,
cuando Jesucristo fue crucificado,
everybody turned their backs except these faithful women.
Todos le dieron la espalda excepto estas dos mujeres fieles.
But they became witnesses.
Pero ellas se volvieron testigos.
The angel says, "Go and testify."
El ángel les dice, "Ve y testifica."
Go and tell of what you've seen.
Ve y di lo que has visto.
There's an empty grave.
Hay una tumba vacía.
For the next 40 days, Jesus would walk around this world presenting himself in person to so many people. Over 500 people, Jesus manifested himself of those that we know in the scripture.
Por los siguientes 40 días, Jesucristo se les manifestaba a aquellas personas que conocían a Jesús. Más de 500 personas han sido testigo de esto.
In 1 Corinthians 15, 3-8,
en 1 Corintios 15, 3 al 8.
I'm going to read it to you. It says, "For what I have received, I passed on to you as of first importance, that Christ died for our sins, according to the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day, according to the scriptures, and that he appeared to Peter, and then to the 12. I'm going to skip down. After that, he appeared to more than 500 of the brothers at the same time, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles, and last of all, he appeared to me also, as to one abnormally born." Yeah, 1 Corinthians 15. It's okay, so we'll put it in Spanish later. Okay. There's this, go ahead.
Lo vas a poner en español en la parte de abajo.
There's this eyewitness after eyewitness account.
Hubo tantos testigos que pudieron ver esto.
You know, if you were to go to court,
si tú vas a la corte,
and somebody was saying that you killed someone,
y alguien dice que tú mataste a alguien,
and somebody says that you did this horrible thing,
y alguien dice que tú hiciste esto cosa horrible,
you would probably be doomed to go to jail.
Tú a lo mejor serás culpado y
unless you could have enough proof that it wasn't you.
Mandarán a la cárcel a menos que tengas prueba que no fuiste tú.
You know, there's something called an alibi.
¿Sabes que hay algo que se llama un alibi en español?
Yeah,
es un testigo.
It's a witness that will say, "I was with him."
Es un testigo que va y que dice, "Yo estuve con él."
All it takes is one person.
Lo único que se requiere es una persona.
That will say, no, he couldn't have done it because I was with that person at the time.
Que diga, no, él no pudo haber hecho eso porque yo estuve con él en ese entonces.
And we weren't in that place.
Y no estábamos en ese lugar.
And another person would come and say, "That's right, I was with that person too. I saw him."
Y otra persona puede venir y decir, "Sí, es correcto, yo estuve ahí
imagine
también."
Imagine if you had more than 500 alibis.
Imagínate que tengas más de 500 testigos.
Tell me that wouldn't be a pretty good case in your favor.
Dime si eso no sería un buen caso a tu favor.
Jesus had more than 500 alibis. He had thousands of alibis.
Jesucristo tenía miles de testigos.
This is why for the first 100 to 200 years, nobody dared to question the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus.
Por eso los primeros 100 y 200 años nadie se llegaba a dudar de la resurrección de Jesucristo.
Let me tell you one more reason why I think Jesus has risen.
Déjame decirte una razón más por la cual Jesucristo ha resucitado.
That is because Jesus turned cowards into conquerors.
Eso fue porque Jesucristo volvió cobardes, de gente que era cobarde a gente victoriosa.
Because in the next days after his resurrection, those that abandoned and would never have given a dime for him.
Porque en los siguientes días después de que los discípulos le abandonaron,
for the next 70 years they would walk and testify of the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus.
Por los siguientes 70 años, ellos testificaron de la muerte y resurrección de Jesucristo.
These disciples of Jesus Christ.
Estos discípulos de Jesucristo.
They walked with Jesus.
Caminaron con Jesús.
In 33 AD in Galilee, Jesus commanded them to spread the gospel.
En 33 después de Cristo en Galilea, Jesús les ordenó que compartieran el evangelio.
In 34 AD, Stephen was stoned to death. 44 AD, James the Greater, brother of John, was beheaded. On 50 AD, Matthew killed by sword. On 61 AD, Barnabas stoned to death. On 63 AD, James the Lesser thrown from the temple, stoned and clubbed. On 64 AD, Peter crucified upside down. On 65 AD, Simon hacked to death. On 65 AD, Bartholomew skinned alive and beheaded. On 67 AD, Paul was beheaded. On 68 AD, Mark dragged through the streets. On 69 AD, Andrew was crucified. On 70 AD, Thomas was speared to death. On 70 AD, Jude shot with arrows to death. On 80 AD, Matthias stoned and beheaded. On 84 AD, Philip crucified. On 84 AD, Luke crucified on an olive tree. On 100 AD, John the Baptist, the last surviving disciple, was boiled in oil and is exiled.
En 34 BC, Esteban es apedreado a muerte. 44 veces, Santiago, el hermano mayor de Juan, es decapitado. 50 veces, Mateo es asesinado con espada. 61 veces, Barnabas apedreado a muerte. 63 veces Santiago, el menos es echado de la cima de un templo apedreado y apaleado. 64 veces Pedro es crucificado boca abajo. 65 veces Simón es apuñalado a muerte. 65 veces Bartolomeo es despellejado vivo y decapitado. 67 veces Pablo es decapitado. 68 veces el cuerpo de Marcos es arrastrado por las calles. 69 veces Andrés es crucificado. 70 veces Tomás muere a punta de lanza. 70 veces Judas muere a punta de flecha. 80 veces Matías apedreado y decapitado. 84 veces Felipe es crucificado. 84 veces Lucas es crucificado en un árbol de olivo. 100 veces Juan, el último de los discípulos en vida, sobrevive, es quemado en aceite hirviente y es desterrado.
For 70 years.
Por 70 años.
These people that turned their back on Jesus.
Estas personas que le dieron la espalda a Jesús.
These men that were so discouraged that they went back to fishing, they went back to do their own trade.
Estas personas que se volvieron a su profesión antigua.
Would turn their lives around.
Le dieron un giro por completo
everything
a sus vidas y entregaron
for
todo
Jesus Christ.
Por Jesucristo.
What fool would die for a lie?
¿Qué tonto moriría por una mentira?
Now some people could die for a lie if they believe it's true.
Hay gente que puede morir por una mentira si cree que es verdad.
But which person would die for a lie knowing that it's a lie?
Pero ¿qué tonto moriría por una mentira sabiendo que es mentira?
These disciples.
Estos discípulos.
They saw Jesus risen.
Vieron a Jesucristo resucitar.
They saw Jesus walk among them.
Vieron a Jesucristo caminar
they
con ellos
después.
They had a personal
experience with Jesus
tuvieron
Christ.
Una relación personal con él.
And this is what gave them courage.
Y por eso esto les dio valentía.
Their stone was rolled away.
Su piedra fue movida.
Their stone of defeat.
La piedra de el derrota.
That stone that told them that God had no power.
Esa piedra que les decía que Jesús no tiene poder.
I want to tell you today.
Quiero decirte hoy.
That every single believer.
Que cada creyente.
Has to come to a conclusion.
Tiene que llegar a una conclusión en su vida.
Jesus is risen.
Jesús ha resucitado.
He has the power.
Él tiene el poder
to roll away any stone
para
from
mover
our lives.
Cualquier piedra en tu vida.
I want to pray for something this morning.
Quiero orar por algo esta mañana.
It's Easter Sunday.
Es día de resurrección.
It's a powerful day.
Es un día poderoso.
It is the most beautiful day for me.
Es el día más hermoso para mí.
It's the day when I can say and confess to the entire world again and again.
Es el día donde yo puedo confesarle al mundo entero una vez más.
My Jesus is alive.
Mi Jesús vive.
My Jesus is alive.
Mi Jesús vive.
My Jesus is alive.
Mi Jesús vive.
Therefore,
por lo tanto,
I will also live.
También viviré.
Therefore,
por lo tanto,
I also have victory.
También tengo victoria.
Therefore,
por lo tanto,
I don't have to worry.
No tengo que preocuparme.
Right where you are in your house.
Porque ahí donde estás en tu casa.
You're surrounded by your family members.
Rodeado de tus familiares.
I want to invite you not into a church or into a religion.
Quiero invitarte no una iglesia o una religión.
But into the victory of a risen Jesus.
Pero la victoria de un Jesucristo que vive.
That you never have to live wondering.
Que nunca tengas que vivir.
What will happen to you?
o preguntándote qué te va a pasar.
After the lights are turned off.
Después de que apagan las luces.
Jesus describes.
Jesús describe
death very differently than the world does.
La muerte muy diferente a como la describe el mundo.
To Jesus.
Para Jesús.
Death is like a wedding day.
La muerte es como un día de boda.
We are his bride.
Nosotros somos la novia.
And he is the groom.
Y él es el novio.
And that day, that beautiful day when they will come together.
Y ese día hermoso cuando lleguen juntos.
You see, I've done many weddings. I've officiated many weddings.
Yo he oficializado muchas bodas.
Next week I'll be in Mazatlán officiating an awesome wedding.
La siguiente semana estaré en Mazatlán oficializando otra boda.
And weddings are a beautiful celebration.
Y las bodas son una celebración hermosa.
If you have Jesus as your Lord and Savior.
Pero si tú tienes a Jesús como tu Señor y Salvador.
If Jesus is risen.
Si
if Jesus is risen for you.
Si Jesús ha resucitado en tu vida.
Then you're also invited to that wedding.
Entonces también estás invitado a esa boda.
Death is also like a graduation.
La muerte también es como una graduación.
To Jesus, death is not a demotion, it's a promotion.
Para Jesús, morir no es bajar un nivel, sino subir un nivel.
Jesus talks about death as though we are going home.
Jesús habla de la muerte como cuando como si fuéramos camino a casa.
He says, in my father's house there are many, many rooms.
Dice, en la casa de mi padre hay tantos cuartos.
I'm going and I'm going to go prepare a room for you.
Yo voy y voy a preparar un cuarto para ti.
To Jesus.
Para Jesús.
Death.
La muerte.
It's not a period, it's a comma.
No es un punto, es una coma.
I want to tell you this morning.
Quiero decirte esta mañana.
Jesus is risen.
Jesús ha resucitado.
You can live a conquering life.
Tú puedes vivir una vida en conquista.
And you can live a life without fear.
Y una vida sin miedo.
A life of power in him.
Una vida en poder de con él.
A life of accountability to a God who loves you.
Una vida en responsabilidad con por el Dios que te ama.
I want to just pray for you.
Por ustedes.
I want to pray that if there's anyone listening this morning that has a stone in their life,
que si hay alguien que está escuchando esta mañana y tiene una piedra en su vida,
maybe it's a financial stone in front of you,
a lo mejor una piedra financiera en tu vida,
that you say, God, I can't move the stone.
Que tú puedas decir, Dios, no puedo mover esta piedra.
Maybe it's in your marriage.
A lo mejor en tu matrimonio.
You say, Lord, there's no way I can move this stone.
Señor, no puedo mover esta piedra.
Maybe the heart of your children has been so hardened, and you say, God, I can't move that stone.
A lo mejor el corazón de tus hijos se ha endurecido tanto y tú dices, Dios, no puedo mover esta piedra.
Maybe you're really trying to follow God, but you have such a hard time, and you say, God, I can't move that stone.
A lo mejor quieres seguir a Dios y no puedes, y tú dices, Dios, no puedo mover esta piedra.
Maybe you have been paralyzed by fear during this pandemic and you want to get out of that fear and you want to believe and you want to conquer again, but there seems to be a stone in front of you.
A lo mejor has sido paralizado por esta pandemia y no puedes vivir y no puedes mover esa piedra.
I want to tell you that God is about to roll away your stones.
Déjame decirte que Dios está a punto de mover esas piedras.
Close your eyes with me and let's pray.
Cierren sus ojos y vamos a orar.
Dear God, thank you so much.
Señor, gracias.
Because you still roll away stones.
Porque sigues moviendo piedras.
Thank you, God, because just as you did that day in front of, oh man, just as you did in front of so many people, Lord.
Gracias, Dios, porque así como lo hiciste en frente de tantas personas.
You presented yourself to hundreds of people.
Te presentaste a cientos de personas.
God, thank you because you still show up in people's lives.
Dios, gracias porque te sigues mostrando en la vida de otras personas.
Thank you, Jesus, because we can experience your freedom.
Gracias, Jesús, porque podemos experimentar tu libertad.
Because those of us that know you, we can be your witnesses.
Porque aquellos que te conocemos podemos ser tus testigos.
Dear Lord, thank you because we can still experience you.
Señor, gracias porque te podemos seguir experimentando.
Because we can experience your love, your freedom, your power, your peace.
Porque podemos sentir tu amor, tu poder, tu paz.
Your purpose, God.
Tu propósito,
thank
Dios.
Thank you so much, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
For dying on the cross.
Por morir en la cruz.
To pay for our sins.
Y pagar por nuestros pecados.
And for resurrecting.
Y por resucitar.
To give us eternal life.
Para darnos vida eterna.
In this Resurrection Sunday,
en este día de resurrección,
we like thousands and millions of Christians around the world.
Nosotros como miles y miles de cristianos en el mundo entero.
Like millions of Christians today, we declare
como,
that you are risen.
Como millones de cristianos declaramos que tú has resucitado.
Jesus, you are risen.
Jesús, tú has resucitado.
Thank you so much, Jesus.
Gracias, Jesús.
We love you so much.
Te amamos tanto.
In your name, we pray.
En tu nombre oramos.
Amen.
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 Let me tell you just one last thing before
Déjame
we go.
Decirte lo último antes de ir.
Today, as you go about your day and this entire week,
hoy mientras continúas con tu vida y la siguiente semana,
I want you to think about this last thought.
Quiero que pienses en lo siguiente.
When these women said, "Who will roll away the stone?"
Cuando estas mujeres dijeron, "¿Quién moverá esta piedra?"
They didn't realize that God had already done it.
No se dieron cuenta que Dios ya lo había hecho.
That the stone was already removed.
La piedra ya había sido removida.
I believe that God has already removed these stones.
Creo que Dios ya ha removido estas piedras.
Don't doubt, believe in God.
No dudes, pero cree en Dios.
And walk in faith.
Y camina en fe.
My God is a stone remover.
Mi Dios es un Dios que mueve piedras.
He already took away the stones.
Él ya movió esas piedras
God
en tu
bless
vida.
You.
Dios los bendiga.
Have an amazing day.
Que tengan un día increíble.
And happy Easter.
Y feliz día de resurrección.
Thank you, Pastor, for that incredible word. If you're blessed by this message, we encourage you to share it with your friends and family on your social media so that they could be blessed too. It might just be what they need to hear. All right, CFF fam, we love you. Hope to see you soon. Stay connected.